Okay, now I'd like to talk about group in a little more detail. By now, you should understand that group's role is really to aggregate its input in some way based on the operators specified. Here are a list of operators that we can use in grouping documents together in the aggregation framework. We've seen some several times. First simply selects the first document in a group. Last, the last document in a group. Max, min, and average all do what you might expect. Based on a numeric value, we're calculating as part of a group. As one example, let's take a look at average. So here we have an aggregation pipeline. And the idea here is to calculate the average number of retweets for any tweets using a particular hashtag. So we do an unwind on the hashtags array of the entities field. And then we're going to group based on the text of the hashtag. So this will give us one document for every hashtag used in a given tweet. So then in the group stage here, we're going to aggregate based on the text, so based on the hashtag itself. And then I'm going to calculate an average based on the field retweet count, which is a top-level field for tweets. Finally, we're going to sort based on the retweet average. Okay, so this gives us an idea of where we might use average and what it looks like. The syntax is very similar to what we've seen with sum. Now, what I'd like to do is nudge this discussion of operators along just a little bit, and I'd like to introduce a couple of additional operators. One is push, and the other is add to set. These are extremely useful operators in a variety of different situations because these are operators that actually deal with arrays. Okay, so let's take a look at an example of where we might use something like this. We're going to look at an example involving add to set. Essentially, what add to set does is, as its accumulation function for a grouping, it adds values to an array, but does so by treating the array as a set. That is, it won't add the same value more than once to the array we're accumulating in. Okay, so here's an example. Now, in this example, what I'm doing is aggregating together all of the unique hashtags and grouping by the user's screen name. So this is essentially all of the hashtags that an individual user has used in their tweets, but we're ignoring hashtags that a user has used in multiple tweets. So here we're going to use add to set to do that. And the way this works is we're going to group. Again, we're going to specify as our ID to define the grouping based on the screen name of the user creating the tweets. Okay? Note that we're unwinding based on the hashtags array. So what we're going to do then is use add to set, and for each hashtag, the actual text of the hashtag, we're going to add that to this array, unique hashtags, that's part of the group document for an individual user. Using add to set ensures that no matter how many times a given hashtag occurs, that is, no matter how many times a user used it in a given tweet, so no matter how many times the group stage sees that text, it will be added one and only one time to this unique hashtags array. And then I'm simply going to do a sort based on ID. So let's run this. Okay, and so all we're getting out is a list of pairings for screen name and a list of all the unique hashtags they've used. Okay, so we can see that for this particular user, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 different hashtags used. We don't know in how many different tweets or how many times. This is essentially the vocabulary of hashtags for this particular user. And if we scroll through here, we'll see the vocabulary of hashtags for all of the users in this collection. Now, what might be more satisfying here is if we were to do something like sort based on the number of unique hashtags that individual users have written as part of their tweets. But that's going to require us to do something we haven't talked about yet, which is using the same operator in more than one group stage in an aggregation pipeline. We'll look at that next.